Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. I'm Eustace Pharmer, and I hope you're all doing well today. So welcome to Gelvin Valley, Episode 9. And in today's episode, we're going to be doing something a little different that I haven't done before on the map. So we're going to be feeding our dairy cattle, and if time permits, we will go ahead and get into the beef cattle because they're a little bit more extensive, because they also take the water and the root crops and then all the usual suspects. So that could be a small portion of another episode in of itself. So let's see how we do on time. But for now, we're going to start out with the dairy cattle, and we have a absolutely massive mix feeder for the mixed ration that I'm going to show you when we get over there. And I glossed over it a bit in the previous episode, episode 8 of this Let's Play, but we'll go over it a bit more again in this one because we're using it in this one. Okay, so we're going to start off with a little bit of Mary bale placement. We're going to need for this mixer, just for one load, we need 7 hay bales and 4 straw bales, and then you top off this mixing wagon with silage. So let me jump into the store right quick and I will show you what I mean. Okay, so here we are in the mod section of the feeding technology, and this is the Peecon Mega Mammut 64, 168,295 pounds, euros, dollars, whatever your currency is in your part of the world. It holds 64,000 liters. That's quite a lot. That's a little over 3 times what the standard mixed ration towable mixed feeder pulls, and I will show you. So 64,000 pounds, it requires 240 horsepower to pull that and 177 kilowatts of power. So let me back out of here and I will show you the next one. Okay, so here we are in the standard in-game feeding technology section, and we're looking at this one right here, the Profile 1880 for $39,000. And it only requires 90 horsepower, but that's because it only has an 18,000 capacity. So this, you could throw a little over about 3.5 of these into this big monster that we're going to be using. So it's, I don't know if we can consider it a time saver or not. We're going to see. It should be interesting. So, yeah, so that little one that we just looked at, that takes 2 hay bales, 1 straw bale, and then a little top off of silage. So it takes a lot smaller amount, but you're doing it many times over. So the mixing ratios are different, as you have seen. So that's why I laid it out for you with the 7 hay, 4 straw, and then the silage. Okay, let me start this up because if you watched episode 4 of their Thornton Farm Let's Play, you would then know that the bale stacking didn't go too well. So let me put it on B, button B, and that should give us the auto load. And I'm just going to drive it up there and let them load on there. So I think it was square hay bales is our first. So we're going to need 14 because I already know that it's going to take part of a second wagon load to feed my cows, because I have 50 cows and I have a little chart that I follow. So I know as I add cows how many mixing wagons it's going to take. And I think in the future I may even be using the CSZ mod. It comes with a whole bunch of attachable implements, and they go on any one of your vehicles that can support an implement. So yeah, we'll be bringing that in future episodes as well. So 14 of these, and then we're going to do 8 straw bales. I wish we can put round and square bales on the same trailer with the auto load. May as well do it from in cab since we don't need much precision. Bring this in a little bit. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to get these loaded up, and then I will be back with you in a second. Alrighty, here we go. So we're all loaded up with our bales. So I have the telehandler on follow me. So we'll go ahead and get going over there. So let's see, we'll press F1 just to get that big long laundry list off the screen. Take off our parking brake. And away we go. Let's see, make sure the straps are still there. It's funny, I'm trying to figure out under what conditions that happens, but sometimes you get out of the tractor and the straps will go missing. So I know when you have auto bale on, when you press B, of course the straps go on, but you have to press B again to shut auto baling off so you can, you know, start transporting. But there's a certain condition where I don't know what I do, but the straps will disappear and the bales will fall off the trailer as I'm driving down the road. Let's make sure our friend is back there. Yep, he's following along. Or she. If I had my daughters on the farm, they'd be working right along with me. At least one of them would. One of them would volunteer. The other one would wait to be asked. But she's a good kid. They're both great. All right, so see, shift and F to get him off of that. Now then, just to avoid any consequences, we're going to go ahead and we're going to drop those down in a convenient spot. Let's see, right about here. All right, we'll turn on our unloading help, which is 6, and that gives us that little red laser square, if you can see it, and then we'll press M to cycle the unloading side. So it's on the back now, and now it's over here, and we press O, letter O on the keyboard, and pa-boom, down she goes. Okay, have it tucked away over here nicely, and let's go ahead, jump into our JCB. That's for you, Osrati Smurf. JCB, not JBC. Like I was saying in one of my episodes, he said he cringed every time I made a mistake and said JBC. Okay. So let's put these over right next to those. And we'll unload these from the back this time. Let's see. Maybe right about there. So let's get our unloading help on. Okay. So let's get her right about here. There we go. Bam. Beautiful. Okay. I'm going to tuck this trailer away. Be back with you in a second. Alrighty, it's time for the main event. Alright, so we're going to start off with the 7 straw. No, we're not. We're going to start off with the 7 hay bales and then put in 4 straw. There we go. Let's extend that a little bit just so we don't bump up against the pile. Nice and nice. Let's play nice. Now, I don't think those went up correctly. That's okay. Good enough. There we go. Alrighty. And of course, I'm not going to have you watch me load them all in. We'll do a couple. And then I'll come back to you when I'm going to do the straw. I like to watch my own videos back. I usually proof watch them before I upload, obviously. And then I actually watch them again once they're uploaded. Because you never know, sometimes YouTube can cause a little problem and the video will cut off at some point. Okay, I'm getting a little lagging with these, and I'm noticing they're a little soft after coming off of that bale trailer. I'm noticing my forks are actually cutting up through the center of the bale. So I may have to look into using another bale trailer in the future. I don't know if that mod is going to work out. Because the bale handling is difficult enough without having extra shenanigans. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and load up the last few, and I'll get back to you with the straw. Now we'll do a couple of straw together. And like I said, I did come up with a few soft ones there, but not all of them. So I don't know what's going on with that. But I think it definitely has something to do with an auto-loading feature. So that's a little disappointing, because this is actually, aside from that, this is actually a really nice mod. But I did notice, I don't know if it's another mod or not, but I did notice that, like on this map, my FPS is really atrocious. It dips down into like in the 40s. And you look up at the sky and I get 144. So there's definitely something going on that I'm going to have to look into. But nothing's crashing. So on with the show is what I say. So there's two. We'll put in the other two together. Get that in. We don't pop the tires of the tractor. All right. There we go. Now I'll go and just pop these forks off and get the bucket, and I'll be right back. Okay, so this is a bucket mod. The bucket is the standard in-game, but the adapter is a mod that came off of the Farming Simulator Mod Hub website. And basically it just allows you to put a wheel loader bucket on a telehandler, which, phew, that saves a lot of trips. And we're about to see how many. There we go, 100%. Hey, something cool on this map. These little barrels here that you find over around in here, if you hit them, they knock over. Watch this. Bam. But when you come back into the map later, they're all set up right where they were. So that's pretty cool. Okay. Let's look at what we're doing. Alrighty. And this is for my friend Chris Bond. I'm using the Satech control deck, and it really does make life easier. The only thing that's you have to get used to is there's a little gray button on top. and you push the button, and when it turns blue, then you have control of your front loading capabilities. You push it again, it turns red, and then you can move your head in different directions. So sometimes I get that mixed up, but that's also because I'm Eustace Pharmer. So it's not that far-fetched to understand that I would get it mixed up. And let's extend this a little more. So to extend it, you're going to hold the little red button. There's a red button on the left. You hold that, and you push to the right with your stick. You'll fiddle around with it, and you'll get it. You're a smart guy. Look at that. ...88%. Wow, we're gonna need another bucket load. I love this stuff. I guess it's a good thing that I love it, because Farming Simulator is my primary game that I record, so like I said, I'm not gonna record games just because they're a fad and popular. I have to really enjoy playing it, because I think, you know, you see people that, you know, follow trends and fads, and they don't have their heart into the game. You know, unless they discover they like it, of course. But, you know, if you're not really enjoying it, it's not your thing, and you're doing it just to get views, it shows. There we go. Let's look from the outside. We don't want to spill. And I did anyway, kind of. Yeah, so see, this thing is a beast. It takes a lot. All right, so now I can do it two ways. I can wrangle around and pull in forwards and then turn around in the cattle field, or I could just back it in. Let's back it in, just to make it easier on this one. There we go. Let's see, we'll just flatten out the top a little bit, sift it down. So as you see, the trailer fits under there nicely. It's just the heap that's clipping. But that's okay. Oh, I gotta choose the tipping side. Okay. Tip side, shift, left shift, and Q. So we'll do it on the right side. Let's see what that does. Beautiful. Okay. Let's look at the list here. Mixed ration, $63,999. So yeah, definitely going to take at least the second wagon load. But to get 100% productivity, we're also going to need to put the straw. Okay. So, I can do the next wagon loads off cam. They've got enough to get themselves started. What we can do now is we can blow in the straw. I brought some, well, I'm not going to say extra straw bales because they were going to be for the second load, but I can, obviously either way I'm going to have to go back and get more, so. Let's just use those for the sake of time, and I could just show you the whole process. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and get my new water bowser off of the trailer and the straw blower, and I'll be with you in a second. Okay, so I did a little experiment, and only the beef and pigs take water, so the sheep and the dairy cows do not. So that's one step you don't have to do with them. So we'll be moving our water trailer and my placeable water fill-up over to the beef farm, and then we'll probably have a water fill-up at the pig farm too, if there isn't one installed over there. And I'm going to put this in the trailer here. Now hopefully we can get it in straight on so it doesn't roll out. This does take square bales as well. I have put square bales in here. Let's see what we got here. No, not even close. There we go. Now hopefully it won't roll out. There we are. I wound up positioning it this way because, you know, going up and down the driveway this way, it would roll out. I always try to test before I come back on camera because I don't like to make a total fool of myself. Okay, in we go. There's the unload point. And let's watch her rip. And of course, I'll just do one with you because, you know, it will take several of these to fill up the straw. And nobody wants to sit through that. 100%. There we go. I notice it takes about 11 minutes, especially when you start the game. You'll even see it say up here, it'll say zero productivity. And then like between 11 and 20 minutes later, it will, you know, catch up. So there we have it. All right. So we're well on our way. We're going to be generating some manure and we're going to be getting some milk. Now on this map, the milk is automatically sold. You don't have the option to cart it. So, but that's okay. There's a lot of great and fun things to do on this map. And I hope you have enjoyed watching this. A little bit of a short episode, especially by my track record and standards, as I've said before. So, yeah. We're going to, in the next episode, we'll get into doing the beef cattle and stuff like that. When it comes to the more kind of mainstream mundane things like this, I want to try to get a little bit more to the point and kind of streamline the length of my videos to be a little shorter. So please do let me know what you think down in the comments section or send me a message any way that you like, private, email, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. I'm on them all. If you look down in the description, you'll see. And if you want any of these mods that you've seen here today, they are in my mods spreadsheet, and that's usually down towards the bottom of my description list. So do go in there and grab anything you like in there. Help yourself. I put it out just for you. Okay, so I hope you have a great morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are in the world, and please be well until we meet again soon. So take care, and bye-bye for now.